drinking bells and sounds and rains, morning colors.
Today we pause to remember the 18 military personnel and two civilians who died here 76 years ago today, when Naval Air Station Kaneohe Bay became the first of several U.S. military installations on the island of Oahu to be attacked by aircraft of the Japanese Imperial Fleet. Today, we are afforded the privilege of gathering aboard Marine Corps Base Hawaii for this solemn occasion. The inscription of the Kaneohe Clipper Monument recalls their sacrifice eloquently, saying, "They gave their today for our tomorrow."
Protect the families, and as we do day in, out, day in and day out, protect the country. Like our narrator described, it was an ordinary day on NAS Kaneohe, probably much like today. Cool air, clear views of the Ko'olau's. The unit stationed here had been on limited alert for over a month. Think about what you'd be doing on a typical Sunday morning here on Marine Corps Base Hawaii. Coffee, Sunday service, chasing kids, running errands, or even just sleeping in. John Finn thought the same thing, even after being told to head over to the hangar. Nothing seemed out of sorts. But as we know, as we look back, that day remains extraordinary. Individual decisions to act, to do what one was trained to do, to pursue and destroy the foe at the cost of one's life. Now, 76 years later, stand in memoriam as acts of heroism. We continue to honor those Americans we lost, sailors, civilian workers, all patriots, all heroes. It's important to continue telling the story of what happened here, to never forget how the men and women of our base continue to shape the history of our military and our country, and how the Battle of the Pacific was won by the Navy and Marine Corps team. And once again, thoughts of war. Immeasurable discomfort sits in the cool air over this base. Over our regiment, over our MAG, over our battalions, over our Navy squadrons. The team on this base must remember the protection of our country depends on it. So today I ask that you take some quiet time to read about this day. I invite you to visit the memorials around Marine Corps Base Hawaii. To remember, I leave you with a quote from George Washington. We should not look back unless it is to derive useful lessons from the past and for the purpose of profiting by dearly bought experience. Thank you for joining us today. Semper Fidelis. Sunday service, chasing kids, running errands, or even just sleeping in. John Finn thought the same thing. Even after being told to head over to the hangar, nothing seemed out of sorts. But as we know, as we look back, that day remains extraordinary. Individual decisions to act, to do what one was trained to do, to pursue and destroy the foe at the cost of one's life, now, 76 years later, stand in memoriam as acts of heroism. We continue to honor those Americans we lost, sailors, civilian workers, all patriots, all heroes. It's important to continue telling the story of what happened here, to never forget how the men and women of our base continued to shape the history of our military and our country, and how the Battle of the Pacific was won by the Navy and Marine Corps team. And once again, thoughts of war and measurable discomfort sits in the cool air over this base. Over our regiment, over our MAG, over our battalions, over our Navy squadrons. The team on this base must remember, protection of our country depends on it. So today I ask that you take some quiet time to read about this day. I invite you to visit the memorials around Marine Corps Base Hawaii. To remember, I leave you with a quote from George Washington. We should not look back unless it is to derive lessons from the past for the purpose of profiting by dearly bought experience.